talking about celebrations, there are certain expressions or grammatical features that can be used in this context or in this topic. So, for example, the use of that or who or whom is something that's very popular or very common in this context. For example, when I say a sentence like New Year's Eve is a celebration, that takes place at the end of the year. So, why am I using that here? That is a relative pronoun. So it's relative because it's related to something else. What is that word related to in the sentence? Let's think before that. If I'm not using that, we'll have only one option. You'll have to have two sentences. The first one will be New Year's Eve is a celebration, full stop, end the sentence. This celebration takes place at the end of the year, which is kind of really wordy and too long. So to avoid this long structure, we put them together with the relative pronoun so we don't repeat the subject. We don't repeat the word twice. So New Year's Eve is a celebration that or which takes place at the end of the year. So now we related them together using this word, which is that. So now we're talking about things, but if you're talking about a person, we don't use that, we use who. So here, people who celebrate Easter's Day go to the parks and have picnics. So here we have who, which is referring to people. And that's the same reason we use who, so we have to avoid using two sentences, and the two sentences will have people. So it's just put together using whom. The last one is whom. And if you look at this one and that one, you will notice that after whom, we have another subject. So here, the people is the subject. And then whom you invite. Here, people who. So that's the subject of the sentence. That's the doer of the action. But here, I invite the people. So the people are the object. So that's why I'm talking about them using whom. So the people whom you invite. So you invite the people. That means the people here is the object, not the subject. And that's why we don't use who, we use whom, but that's in a very formal context. If you replace it with who, that would be totally fine. But grammatically speaking or formally speaking, it should be whom. So the people whom you saw, the person whom you got married to. So that's like who is the subject, and then here is the subject, and here is the object. So the people whom you invite to the party should bring a gift. That's where you use whom, and you can use that, and you can also use who. Let's try another sentence. The girl whom you hired is awesome, or is doing a great job. If you look at this one here, you are the doer of the action. You're the subject. And then you hired who? You hired the girl. So the girl whom you hired is great, or is nice, or is whatever. Can we replace that with something else? Yes, we can say the girl who you hired, or the girl that you hired. The three of them will be okay, but that's the kind of like the most formal format. Hopefully this was useful, and see you next video. Thank you very much.